no use. With my mind control serum coursing through their brains, resistance is futile!
I'm really lousy at taking orders. Ask Leo!
We'll see.
Okay, that is disgusting.
Raphael is mine now to control. As are your other mutant friends.
No escape for you, reptiles.
Raph?
Raph, snap out of it, man! Shredder's the enemy!
You are the enemy!
I think I get it! You can't feel emotion because you're Shredder's puppet! As a matter of fact, I'll bet you like doing whatever Shredder tells you! You probably love it!
Hey guys, welcome back to the Fatal Raph channel. We are doing Raph's Rage today. Now we have done Raph's Rage before, so I'm not going to go through every single battle, but we're going to go over the characters and the DNA that you get on each level. So for the character part, there's not a whole lot of selection that you get off of this. Very limited. And for the most part, they're not very good. You got a few that are good in here, and your only healer is Pitch and Pete. But overall, not a very good selection. So there's a chance that Raph could win at this one. Unless you have this little bit here pretty high leveled, this one's going to be a tough one. You get the Creep, Pigeon Pete, Fish Face, Dog Pound, Casey Jones, Spider Bites, Rocksteady, and Zephyr. And that's it. In the first stage, you get Movie Raphael. And that's it. The next stage, you'll get Nick Raph and Movie Raph. Third stage, BQ Raph, which he's really good. Nick Raph and Movie Raph. Then you get LARP Raph, who's also really good. BQ Raph, Nick Raph, and Movie Raph. Stage 5, you get Classic Raph, LARP Raph, VQ Raph, and Nick Raph. Stage 6 gives you Original Raph, Classic Raph, LARP Raph, and VQ Raph. And the final stage, if you can make it this far, is Space Raph with Original Raph, Classic Raph, and LARP Raph. So those are the Raphs that you get on this stage. And what I experienced with it for the most part was I was able to do automatic play up to stage 5. Then I had to do manual play on stage 6. Probably gonna have to do manual play on stage 7, and either you're gonna win it or you won't. Just depends on how high level you have everybody. Where I'm at, it probably looks like I'm not going to 3 star. I could potentially 1 star, but that's probably gonna be about the best I can do. So that's Raph's Rage. The other one you get is Vigil of the Vigilantes, and I'm not going to go over this one very much, except for the fact that when we had the Rockwell tournament, I didn't get the DNA for that. So this is a perfect spot to go and make up for that. I kind of been waiting for this one to come along. Rockwell shows up on stage 3 before you get the Muckman DNA. And you have a better selection of characters here. So with this set, we can get a lot farther. As you can see, they have more to choose from and a better selection. So we'll get a lot farther with that. Where I got was up to here. I pretty much did automatic play. And then Leatherhead is where I did a manual play. And I'll have to do a manual play on Slash. On the first stage, they start off with Mondo DNA. Second stage, you get Pigeon Pete, Kirby Bat. Third stage is where I'm gonna start. Rockwell DNA, Pulverizer, Kirby Bat. Fourth stage, you get Leatherhead. So if you can't beat Leatherhead stage, you can get him here. Muckman, Pulverizer, and Kirby Bat. Stage 5, Slash DNA if you need that. He's also in the tournament this week, so you can get him there too. Mondo, Muckman, Pulverizer. Stage 6, Rockwell, Pigeon Pete, Mondo, Muckman. So I'll also be grinding this Stage 6 as well too to get my Rockwell DNA. Leatherhead, you get Leatherhead, you get Rockwell, Pigeon Pete, Muckman. That's stage 7. Stage 8 is Slash. You get Slash DNA, Leatherhead DNA, Rockwell DNA, and Pigeon Pete DNA. So I'll probably be grinding stage 7, stage 6, and most likely stage 3. So I can get my Rockwell DNA that I was supposed to get from the tournament, but didn't get it. Not that I need it. I know I don't need any DNA, but I mean, it's a principle of it. If I want to go back and get what they didn't give me, this is the opportunity to do so. So that is what we're looking at this week for this week's challenges. And there's slash the tournament. If you want more of a in-depth look and a playthrough of these two challenges, I'm going to post on the end card a more in-depth look of Vigil of the Vigilantes and Raph's Rage, where we actually went through and battled everybody. But since this is repeats, we don't really need to do that. So we're just going over the characters that you can use and what DNA you get on each level. And the playthroughs will be found in other videos on this channel, so check that out. So like this video, subscribe to the channel if you're not already subscribed. And hit me up on Cameo. I'm on there and I can make you a personal video. And check out the playthroughs of Vigil of the Vigilantes and Raph's Rage on this channel as well too. Posted at the end of the video so you can see the battle playthrough of each one and just how easy or difficult they are. And feel free to let me know in the comments how far you get on each one of these challenges. Alright. So that is the challenges for the week. Thank you for tuning in. And we will see you in the next TMNT Legends video. Check out the rest of the playlist if you're not already caught up. Check out other TMNT content on this channel. And also check out other gaming content on this channel because we got a wide variety of stuff. Thank you for watching. We'll see you in the next video.